In this tutorial, you need to make calculations in a form. First, you'll create the form in which you're going to make the calculations, or if it is already created, then open it. For example, I'm going to use a form called phone orders in my database. Open the design view of this form. This is how the design view looks like. You're going to add a field in this form in which the calculation is to be performed. But when you look at this design view, it does not give you the space where you can add that field. So what you do, you move the footer section down so that you get that space. In the tools up here, there are different controls in the form which we can use. But if you want to make a calculation, then you are going to use the text box control. You click on text box. It is here. You notice that the pointer changes shape. It becomes a plus and then letters A, B. Take that pointer to the position where you want to insert your field. Press and hold the left button of your mouse and draw the field. There it is. These boxes come when they are two. There is one labeled as text 13 or text 12 or whichever. Then there is one labeled as unbound. You notice that the unbound text box has handles because it is the one which is highlighted. Those handles can be used to expand or to reduce the size of that box. You can move these boxes until they align well with the rest of the boxes up that were pre-created. In this box which has text 13, I am going to add the field name. For example, in this form, I want to calculate the total price using the unit price and quantity. So I type in the field name as total price. In the unbound box, I put the formula. In a form, a formula begins with an equal sign. I hope you can see that to get the total price, it is actually the unit price times the quantity. Now, you must note that if something is a field within the table and you want access to look up the values which are in the table and use them in this calculation, then you surround the field names in this formula with square brackets. This is how the formula looks like. Click save. Open the form in form view. I think you can see clearly that automatically the total price has been computed here. You can check with the other forms and you see, check this part of the total price. It has been computed successfully. Let's look at another scenario where every client is given a discount of 5% of this total price. We shall do the computation the same way we did with total price. So open the form in design view and then you insert a field using the text box. Remember, in the box which is displaying text 15, we type the field name. For this case, the field name is discount. In the box which is called unbound, we are going to type the formula. Remember, you must begin with equal sign. Now, Access does not understand the percent symbol. For example, let me first try to use the percent symbol and you see the result it gives. Equal to 5% of total price. Remember to put total price in the square brackets to tell Access that look, this one is from the table. Okay, have you seen? It returns an error, which is you omitted an operand or operator, that the expression you entered contains an invalid syntax. So what do we do? In this case, we convert the 5% to decimal. It becomes 0.05. That is what we should use. So after converting it to 0.05, click save, click view, form view. Sorry, total price does not exist in the table, so it has no values. That's why the system is returning an error. Instead of using total price, we shall use the formula which we use to compute the total price in calculating the discount. In this case, we shall say 5% times quantity times unit price. Quantity is a field in the table, so surround it with square brackets. Unit price is also a field in the table, so surround it with square brackets. Click Save. My computation of the discount is now successful. One more calculation. You will calculate the age of the customer given the date of birth. Now open the customer's form. Go to Design View. Move the footer section down. Click Text Box. Draw the box down here. In Text 21, you type age. In the unbound text box, you type in date diff. That is the function. Open brackets, open quotes, and then type 4Ys to represent year, and close quotes. Put a comma, because computations in database and in Excel, we use commas to separate arguments. Then type date of birth. The spelling must be exactly the way it is in the table. If you typed in a full word, date of birth, then here you type it as a full word. But if you use the short form like I used, DOB, that is what you should use. Because DOB values should be picked from the table, then surround DOB with square brackets. Put a comma to separate the argument. Then date now, written as date, then open a bracket, close bracket, without any arguments. Then close the whole bracket now. This is how the function looks like. Open the form in form view. Yeah, you can see the result is there in the form. The age has been computed using the year. If you look at this function very well, you realize that in your function, you're telling the system that get the date difference or the difference in date, considering years only. Yeah, that is it. That's how we perform calculations. We started by computing the total price, followed by the discount. We saw the difference that if you're computing something which is like 2%, then it is 0.02. If it is 30%, then it is 0.3. You have to convert to decimal. When it came to the date, things changed. We used a function called dateDiff. I wish you the best in your calculations in database forms using Access. If you want to learn more about databases, please like this video, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so that you're always notified whenever I release such tutorials. See you in the next one.